Hello, everyone. So my name is Wes Allen, for those of you who don't know me. And for those of you who do, let's say what's up to my students. So unfortunately, today we can't be at Daniel Spectrum to do our music lessons. But I was thinking we could take this opportunity to do a little field trip. So who knows where we are now? See if you can figure it out. What if we just drop right in here? Where are we? Ah, there we are. Ready for music lessons. Yeah, like I said, we can't go in today. But I wanted to take this opportunity to go to another place. And that's because I've been listening to music from this place for a little while now, and I really love it. And I thought it would be really fun to share a little bit about what I know with you guys. So we're going to go to Cuba. Now, here we are, Cuba. Now, Cuban music is really unique and really beautiful. And there's lots of different kinds of Cuban music. But Cuban music was developed by the people that lived there long ago. And that live there now, but this specific style was developed by people who lived there quite a while ago. And it was made up. Cuban music is the way it is because of a certain culture clash. And that's because when the Europeans moved over to North America in the 1600s, when they colonized, they brought with them a lot of West African slaves. It's a pretty dark history, but the combination of those two cultures really made some beautiful music. So there were a lot of rhythms from West Africa that combined with harmony and chords and melodies from Spain and France a little bit. And it made this beautiful fusion of music that developed in Cuba. There was lots of different styles that came out of this. Some of them are son, danzón, and bolero. There's lots more though. There was tons of music being made here, tons of unique, amazing music being made here. And then in the 1900s, things got a little rocky politically with Cuba. There was a bunch of events that happened before the 1900s. There was the Cuban Revolution against Spain when they fought for their freedom there. And then there was the Cuban Revolution within Cuba. And then there was the Cold War and the Cuban Missile Crisis. So there was a lot of political strife here, but there's still a lot of amazing music. So a lot of this music wasn't really recorded until the 90s. And there are some recordings, but some really great recordings were made in the 90s when this producer, Ry Cooder, came down from America and he recorded a bunch of albums there. He found a whole bunch of musicians that hadn't been playing that much and he made a bunch of really cool albums. And so some of these albums that you want to check out, some of these artists and albums that you want to check out are this album by Ruben Gonzalez, which is super awesome. There's this artist, Israel Cachao Lopez, really amazing. And there's this record, the Buena Vista Social Club. And this band, the Buena Vista Social Club, they were kind of like the Avengers in that they were all a whole bunch of amazing musicians that were put together for this one project. So yeah, I recommend that you check out all of these things and just listen to it. See if you like any of this kind of music. I'll add some links in the description of the video. I'll also add some cartoons about the Cuban Revolution, the Cold War, and the Missile Crisis if you're curious about the history of Cuba. And that's it for today. Thanks so much, guys. One more thing. This place, you guys might recognize this name, Havana. That song, that popular song, Havana Unana, that's about this place in Cuba. So that's it for me, folks. I look forward to seeing you when I see you. And keep practicing, keep listening to music, and I hope you're all doing well and staying healthy. Thanks.